Did you know that the last part of the setup is the easiest part? All we're going to do is input and manage client and vendor data. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. Did you know that the last part of the setup is the easiest part? All we're going to do is input and manage client and vendor data. This is simple name data that we need to record on our lists before we can start making transactions. We will put the names, addresses, phone numbers, etc. of all the clients in our law firm. We will also put into QuickBooks Online the names, addresses, and phone numbers of the vendors who give us the service and products that we need to be able to run the law firm. Please note, anyone whom you pay is not an employee, is a vendor. Their data must go on the vendor's list. This means they are a 1099 worker. Even associate attorneys who do not work exclusively or consistently for the law firm should be on the vendor's list and receive a 1099 instead of a W-2. So, here are the example names of clients that we will put in, and here are the example names of the vendors that we will use to learn about this area of QuickBooks Online data. Please note again, however, that we will skip all data except for the name. You can revisit these windows and input the other personal identifying data after you finish this video. So, let's just read from the screen and put it into the right place. Now, for customers, you can click Sales, and then under this, in the Sales window, you can click Customers. Now, if this is the very first time that you're opening up the customer list, you will see this window. And we are not importing them from Excel. That's a different video. We will click Add Customer manually, and I'm only going to put the name in the company field and display name as field. I leave the cap locks on, and that's it. Then I click Save. Now, how can I see this? Well, right now I'm still in that one customer's record. But if I click Customers, I see this name as one on a future list. New customer, again, company, let's make it nice. And it automatically puts it to display name and save. Okay, now we're in this customer's records, this client's records specifically, and if we click customers, we get it as a list. We can go back to Betty's records by clicking here, and you see that this is the client whose attention we have, and you can see all, you could see all the list of transactions right here when we have them, details about their name, address, phone number, and so on, and any late fees that you might charge them. But this information comes from putting it in, and if you need to edit this information, you can click Edit, and you can add the address, you could change the phone number, or do anything you want right here from the customer's list. The most important feature in this window is the notes. You can type in any notes you want that will help you remember specific things about this client and then click Save. Okay, so it'll show over here when you click customers and you choose the specific customer and you choose customer details. And later when we have transactions, they will all be listed here, listed in date order by customer. Let's go back to the customer list, put in a new customer. The last one will be push tab so that it copies it to the display field and then click save. Now you can see all of Candy's transactions and all the details you put in the little window we opened a moment ago, and you can edit this to change any of their permanent information and then click save. And we'll do the same thing with vendors. Under expenses, you can click vendors. And if this is the first time going to your vendor list, we will not import because that's a different video. We will add vendor manually. And we will just simply copy over the names, Staples, Office Max, Post Office, etc. Tab, it copies it to the display, save. Okay, now new vendor, Office Max. You may notice that in this window, we also have notes regarding vendors, just like we have notes for customers. So you can open up the permanent vendor data and in the notes field, type in anything that helps you remember what you may need to remember about that vendor. And everything else is permanent data that you have at your fingertips just by clicking expenses, vendors, and coming over to the vendor tab. You can edit any of the vendor information by double-clicking on the name. And then, of course, when that particular vendor is in front of you, you would click edit, and you can edit the details and put in the notes. So it's very simple. Now, see if you can put these remaining four on the vendor list yourself after I finish this video, and see if it's just as easy as opening it up and re-entering or editing anything you need. Congratulations, you're finished with the setup, and our next video will be our first law firm transaction.